Do you think you have what it takes to complete this impossible quiz that only 0.001% of people can solve?
From solving crazy Project Playtime riddles to answering mind-blowing quizzes with insane plot twists, these videos will keep you at the edge of your seat.
Watch till the end to see what happens when LankyBox took a real-life IQ test.
Let's go!
Now we have to choose which brawn is correct, and it looks like the difference is his teeth. Now I really don't know what his teeth are supposed to look like, so this is hard.
This is tricky, guys.
I feel like it's number three. Number one looks kind of weird. Number two, you think he has no teeth? No, dinosaurs have teeth. Dinosaurs have teeth, guys?
I think so. I'm trying to think back to Poppy Playtime Chapter 2. Brawn is in there. I think he has teeth.
I think it's number three. Number three looks the most real.
Let's go ahead and lock in number three.
All right, let's see if that's right. One, we got that wrong. Okay, next we got Gru from Minions, Rise of Gru.
Wow, guys. So play along at home. See if you can actually get more of these correct than we do.
Okay, I have no idea what's even different about him.
What? Well, the nose on three is different.
Oh, okay, and the nose on two is different also.
Got it. Okay, so which nose is correct?
Which nose is right? Now, we recently saw the Minions movie. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it was great, guys.
We saw the first 3 minutes before we got kicked out of the theater. I don't think it's number three.
How come?
I just don't remember him looking that way.
Yeah, number two looks right to me, but also number one looks good.
I'm gonna go with number one. What are you gonna go with, Aiden?
I'll go ahead and lock in number one as well.
Okay, Adam's just gonna copy my answer. Let's see what happens. It was number one. Let's go. Oh my goodness. Which knuckles.exe is correct?
Oh wow, guys. Oh. Knuckles.exe is super scary.
Okay,
now
they're missing the arms. Okay, the difference is number three, his shoes are different.
Uh-huh.
And number two, he's missing the pointy spikes.
Right, exactly.
I think he does have pointy spikes. Isn't that why he's called Knuckles?
Yeah, I do think he has the spike, so it's not number two. But the shoes, I'm not sure which ones are right.
Pretty cool shoes, huh?
Yeah. Knuckles.exe is so scary, guys. He would punch you to ooh.
What? He's missing an arm, though. What if his spikes, like, fell off also? What if it is number two?
Maybe.
You don't know. You don't know.
I'll go ahead.
You don't know.
I'm gonna lock in number one.
You don't know.
I'm gonna lock in number one.
Okay, why?
Only because I feel like the yellow shoes look good. I don't know why, guys.
You like him?
I have a good feeling. I wish I had shoes like that.
I'm gonna lock in number one also because he got the spikes and the yellow shoes. So I'm gonna try that. We got it right and we were guessing. Let's go. Okay, next up we got Meow. We got Gary the Snail. And we gotta guess based on the pattern on his shell.
I have no idea what the pattern is.
I got your back like Gary's shell.
Like a snail shell.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Now guys, try to think when you're watching SpongeBob, what has the shape of Gary's shell?
Foxy says we got to hang out with SpongeBob recently.
Wait, you hung out with SpongeBob?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Pretty lit, huh?
Oh, man.
The characters are pretty lit. We didn't get to do that.
I know. I wish we could have done that.
Okay. I don't think it's number three, because that's just a bunch of dots.
Yeah, number two looks right to me.
You think it's number two? Yeah. Is it number two or number one? Then the swirly looks really good.
No, I think it's number two.
I'm going to lock in number one. Adam's going to lock in number two. Everyone, lock in your guesses right now at home. Do it right now. Here we go. It was number one. How many arrows are in a game of Friday Night Funkin'? Now, this is really tricky, guys. This is a 99% fail test that we found online. It's real difficult. I think there's four, because there's four arrow keys. You know what I mean?
Oh, right. That's true.
Four
yeah.
But what if it's eight? Because there's four arrows for each player.
Oh, right. On the left side, there's four. And I think on the right side, there's also four.
Is it four or eight then? That makes no sense. Guys, let us know. Is it four? I'm going to go with four.
Okay, I think the answer to this is eight only because there's the two pairs of four.
All right, I'm going to go four. Adam's going to go eight. Let's see what we got, dude. It was eight. No, I had that.
Guys.
Okay, now what isn't a line from Talking Ben? I know all of his lines. See, I'll just do them first. I don't know. He picks up the phone and goes, bring, bring. And he goes, man.
Yes?
No. Ugh. And then he hangs up. That's it.
Right.
So which ones did I do?
You did Ben.
Byron. I did that one.
That's A and B.
And he says, yes?
Yep.
And he goes, no.
That's D.
And he goes, ugh.
Does he say maybe?
Well, maybe the ugh is his way of saying maybe.
Maybe. Yeah, that maybe. Might be it. Although, I think you got them all, so I feel like C might be the right answer.
Guys, let us know in the comments if you give these right. I think it's C. I don't think he says maybe, because then he'll have to say, Maybe. I would remember that.
Yeah, right.
I think it's C, guys. It was! Yeah! Okay, now this is real tricky, guys. Where in Poppy Playtime do you meet Cat B? So this little animal for the first time.
Right. Okay, guys. These are going to get trickier and trickier. Let us know in the comments after you're done with this video how many you got right.
This is real tricky. Outside the factory, I'm pretty sure you start the game in the factory, so that's impossible.
Right, that's
true. In chapter 1, you start in the factory. Mm-hmm. Make a friend machine. Is this the toy you get in Make a Friend? Or is that Bunzo Bunny?
Oh, man, this is tricky. Poppy's room.
Guys, these are impossible difficulty, guys. This is going to be real tricky. Poppy, yeah, there might be one in the corner of Poppy's room. We don't remember. Like when you open the glass case and she goes, you opened my case.
Right, I'm trying to think if there's a Cat B in
the
corner.
Or is it in the vents?
The vents would make a lot of sense because you're in the vents for a lot of Poppy playtime.
The vents would make sense.
Right, but where do you meet Cat B for the first time? Well, you aren't really in the vents until after the Make a Friend machine.
Like, yeah.
You make the toy in the machine.
In chapter 1, yeah.
Then you go to the vents.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's the vents. I don't think it's outside the factory because you never go outside the factory.
So you're confusing me. Hey, why don't you just tell us your guess?
I think it's either B, Make a Friend machine, or C, Poppy's room. I'm gonna go ahead and go with Poppy's room only because I think you make Bunzo Bunny in Make a Friend, not Cat B.
I'm gonna go with Make a Friend machine because we make some toy, but I don't know what it was. It might have been Brawn.
All right, let's see it.
All right, let's go. It was!
Nice!
Okay, now how many members are in PJ Masks? That's real tricky, bro.
Oh,
that's not easy. This might be a trick question, guys. Now this looks easy, just like the Friday Night Funkin' Arrows, but it's not. What was so funny? Like,
well, I'm trying to think. Do they count Romeo?
That's what I'm saying.
As a member of PJ Masks?
Or the Night Ninja?
Right, the Night Ninja!
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Or Luna Girl.
Oh, Luna Girl.
No. Funny.
Okay,
this is serious.
Obviously, we all know Catboy, so that's one.
Yeah.
We got Gecko.
Gecko.
That's two.
Yep.
Owlette is three.
That's three.
Now, Romeo, does that count as four?
Romeo.
And does Night Ninja count?
That would be five. Dude, so we know the villains don't count because if they did, there would be six, and that's not an answer. Look how big my brain is!
So what do you think the actual answer is?
Look how big my brain is, guys. See that? Because Catboy, one. Owlette, Gecko, Romeo, Night Ninja, Luna Girl, that's six, and that's not a choice here. So we know, using our brains, that it can't be counting the villains. So it's got to be three. It's got to be just Gecko, Catboy, and Owlette.
If Justin gets this right.
And oh, it's four. It's me, because I'm in the PJ Masks.
He is actually a hero of the night. Let's see if three is the right answer.
I'm locking three.
Let's go! Got it! Oh.
Okay, now it's saying, what year did Roblox come out? How am I supposed to know that?
I mean, you need like a time machine to know that.
I have no idea. Wait, what? How are we supposed to know this?
Okay, what year did it come out? 2000.
That year hasn't even happened yet, so it can't be that one.
2005, 2010, or 2015. I have no idea on this one. I'm gonna guess.
I'm gonna use logic, I'm gonna get it.
All right.
Watch.
Break it down.
Watch this. Can't be 2000, that year has not happened yet. We are reverse aging, so it's not there yet. 2005. 2005, subtract the 5 and you get 2000, which also has not happened yet. It couldn't be that one. I'm gonna look at my Roblox gift card. Phone a friend. Phone a friend.
Okay, Justin's dialing on the gift card.
I see it.
Uh-huh.
See Roblox gift card? See that $25?
Yeah.
2005. I'm gonna lock in 2005, and if I got it right, I'm a genius and nobody could tell me anything else.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just randomly guess 2010, so C?
It's either 2005 or 2010, I'm pretty sure. Like I said, year 2000 has not happened yet. And 2015, I feel like that's too recent.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, so it's either B or C. I'm gonna lock in C, Justin locked in
B. I'm gonna go B. I'm gonna go 2005, guys, let's go. Let's go! I'm a genius!
Wow, he was right about everything he just said.
Everything I just said was true, guys.
Wow.
Everything, scientifically proven. Okay, now what land animal can open its mouth the widest? What?
So, there's one animal here that can open its mouth wider than anybody.
Aiden, when he sees some... Open wide, Aiden. Open wide, Aiden. Ow, there you go.
Milky.
Milky, milk, milky, milk. Is it an alligator can open it really wide.
That's true.
Alligator, crocodile, those are the same animals. That doesn't even make any sense.
A baboon is like a
What's
monkey.
What's that? It's a like balloon? It's not an animal.
No, a baboon. It's like a mix of a monkey and a gorilla.
What?
Yeah, it's like in between. Or
no, that's an orangutan.
Right, I think baboons and orangutans are pretty similar.
What's a baboon?
It's like a monkey.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll put up an image on screen of a funny looking baboon.
Okay, if it's a baboon, if that's a monkey, I don't think the monkeys can open their mouths super wide unless it's like a special kind of monkey.
Right, that's true.
Cause I always hang out with the monkeys at the zoo.
Not in the cage.
No, obviously not. Who does that?
Right. Or is it a hippo?
A hippo can also open its mouth pretty wide. I've seen one at the zoo eat a whole watermelon.
Right, that's true, guys.
This is not even right, dude. This quiz is messed up. I don't know why I say Lanky Box quiz.
I'm gonna go ahead and lock in baboon.
Why though?
Because I feel like in nature, if they were needing to eat like a giant banana, they would have to do it.
Nike, just do it. Do you think baboons wear shirts that say Nike on them? They see a big banana and they say, just do it.
Yeah, maybe.
I'm gonna say you're wrong.
What do you think it is?
I'm gonna use process of elimination. Even though this is clearly wrong. What land animal? Dude, it's a blue whale. Cause blue whale is huge. It opens the mouth huge. It was so funny.
What was that little chuckle you just did?
That's me being smart.
Okay, well, you're gonna guess.
It's a blue whale.
What land animal can open its mouth? Oh, and you said a whale.
Oh, land. Okay.
Okay, just
no,
to get
it well. No, I take it back. It's not, no. I'm smart. See, this is my time to shine. Everybody thinks Jesse a dummy. I'm not, guys. Alligator, crocodile, that's like the same animal, so it can't be those. Because that's scientifically, cybernetically the same,
okay?
With the DNA. Okay, baboon is a kind of monkey. I don't think monkeys is probably not that crazy. I have to go hippo. I don't know, but I'm guessing. I'm going to show you guys this is how geniuses think, bro. I'm going to prove it.
Okay.
That's a hippo.
He's going to prove it.
What? You need what? You need to prove it? You need to poop it. Go.
No.
Go.
No. Let's see the answer.
I ain't gonna poop it.
No, I don't.
Go then. Why'd you say that then?
Cause you said it.
I didn't say that. I said I'm gonna prove it. You need to go poop it. Go.
All right. Let's see the answer.
I'm a genius.
It was hippo.
And you know how I also got that one? I didn't even leak. I leaked this strategy. It's too high IQ.
Wow.
If you rearrange the letters of hippo, it spells IHOP. And I eat a lot of IHOP. And like IHOP, the stack of pancakes, you have that open real wide to eat them. That's how fast I'm thinking.
Wow, that's smart.
You see what I'm saying? Okay, now what is this, bro? What is the biggest planet in our solar system? How are we supposed to... I don't know. I haven't even left this room. How
okay.
Okay, it's obviously the sun.
Well, okay.
Or the moon. The moon's huge. Elon Musk trying to go to the moon.
He lives there.
What?
Mercury, Earth, Jupiter, or Saturn? Which is the biggest planet?
This is a trick question. None of those are planets except for the Earth.
Well, then what are they?
I don't know.
Hmm.
Ask Rocky. Rocky says, my dad's a meteor. He knows.
Do you know the answer to this one?
Yeah.
What's the answer? What's the biggest planet?
My dad.
Your dad is the biggest planet in our solar system?
He's a meteor, and he's huge.
I know, but is he bigger than a planet?
He's real big.
Yeah, but is he bigger than a planet?
What are you trying to say?
Planets are massive. The answer?
It's the sun, dude. It's the sun. That's a trick question.
I'm just going to go eeny, meeny, miny, moe, and I'm going to guess Mercury.
What is that? Mercury?
Mercury is a planet.
No, it's not, bro.
I think it is.
Sun, moon, Earth.
Planets. Yeah.
Those are the planets.
All right. Well, then
I'm actually not sure, guys. Even though I do work for NASA, nothing I say you should use in school. I'm just showing you how my brain works, and I think it's the sun.
Okay.
Which is not an answer here. Oh!
Did they sneakily add it
yep,
in?
Yep, because the word sun is in this one, Saturn.
And if you take out ATR.
Sat.
So if you take out ATR.
Saturday.
Then it's
Saturday. It's the first letters of Saturday. And you take out the ATR, it spells sun. And the sun is the biggest one.
Okay, so Justin's gonna lock in Saturn. I'm gonna lock in Mercury.
Wait a minute. No, I take that back, dude. We're so dumb, dude.
What?
Look at the photo. It tells us the Earth is the biggest.
Okay, you wanna change your answer?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Justin's gonna lock in Earth, and I'm gonna lock in Mercury.
Yeah, the picture shows us, man, I didn't know the sun was that small.
Yeah. And really close.
What?
All right, let's see what it is.
I'm gonna lock in Earth.
It was Jupiter.
No, none of us guessed that one. What is that? What is that?
That's the Earth next to Jupiter.
No, it's not.
So I guess Jupiter is like 1,000 times bigger than the Earth.
That can't be real.
If any of you guys out there are like geniuses, like baby geniuses, hey, you probably knew that.
If any of you guys got that, you're an actual certified genius. I will get you an interview with Elon Musk. Okay, this is impossible. How many colors are in a rainbow? What?
Okay, guys, we're gonna put up an image of a rainbow.
There's one
here.
Right there.
Now, how many colors are there?
Red, yellow, blue, 3.
What about
because
green?
Because all other colors are made from red, yellow, blue.
Oh.
It's 3.
So the number of colors in a rainbow is 3, which is not even an answer.
I'm smart. I know what it is. If I get a bag of Skittles, they taste the rainbow. So if I know how many colors are in Skittles, I'll know.
Okay.
Purple ones, yellow ones, red ones, green ones, orange ones. So that's 5.
Yep.
So I'm gonna round up to 6. It's 6. It's C. See that? Look at how smart my brain is. Just zooming around.
Well, I'm trying to think. Because my mom always teaches us about colors. And I'm trying to think of...
She always teaches you. I already passed that.
She sometimes will sing a song to me, and I think that...
She doesn't sing to you.
She did.
She puts out Coco now.
She did, and
she
remember...
She puts out Leggybox channel and their lit videos.
Yeah, and I think she sang this song one time that was really catchy that goes, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. And I think that means there's 7. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple.
Yo. Hey, yo. Hey, yo.
So I'm gonna lock in 7.
Hey, yo. You need to go back. You need to go to Lakeybox channel and watch some lit videos about numbers and colors, bro. You failed color school and counting school.
So you're gonna lock in 6?
Yeah. Foxy says we got a lit song about 1, 2, 3s coming out. You can watch that one.
Okay.
You need to, bro.
All right, let's see what the answer is here.
Dude, if I get a 6, I'm a genius. I literally used the Skittles method and I got it.
I got it right!
How did he get it right going red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, and then saying 7? How did you get it right? This is a hack. You're cheating!
I'm not!
You are cheating! How is there 7 colors in a rainbow? Explain that! Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple. How's that 7?
I don't know!
You're hacking. Now, where is the fastest muscle in the human body?
Is it the arm, the eye, the fingers, or the leg?
The eye is not a muscle! That doesn't even make sense.
That's true.
Is it?
Fingers are pretty quick, but I think those are bones.
My legs are so quick.
Justin has a lot of muscles in his arms.
It's not saying what the biggest muscle is, it's the fastest. My legs are super fast. Adam can never catch me. We're playing tag, never catch me a day in his life.
That's true.
I'm so fast.
That is true.
I'm going legs, and the hint is the flash, so it's gotta be legs. Easy.
I'm gonna go with the fingers.
Why?
Because I feel like when you go like this, it's really fast.
What happened when I go like this?
Guys, let us know which one is faster.
You couldn't even see me.
That's true.
I'm going D, the legs.
One of us is right. I know
Adam's
that for
go
sure.
I'm gonna go C, the fingers.
Okay.
What?
The eye?
The eye's not muscle.
What is it?
I don't know. What is that? Oh, bruh. What instrument does Squidward play?
Okay, is it the flute, the guitar, the clarinet, or the banjo?
Okay, this is tricky, guys. Now, I'm 50-50 right here, because I can narrow it down. It's either the flute or the clarinet. I don't think it's guitar or banjo. I think he plays something like that.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think Montgomery Gator plays the guitar, but not Squidward. I think Squidward plays the flute.
Does he go like this? The flute goes like this, or does he go like this with the clarinet?
I feel like he goes like this.
That's the clarinet, I know.
Okay, then I'm gonna lock in clarinet.
I'm gonna go clarinet, bro. I'm pretty sure it's a clarinet.
All right.
I don't know what that is, though. Let's go!
All right!
Big brain. What is the coldest place on Earth? Adam's mom's heart.
Okay, is it Santa's workshop, the South Pole, Antarctica, or the refrigerator?
Oh wait, the fridge. The fridge is really cold.
The fridge is very, very cold. Although, isn't the freezer colder than the refrigerator?
Yeah, it's part of the refrigerator though.
Oh, okay. Okay, that makes sense. Now,
the Santa's workshop's gotta be pretty cold though. No, it's not, because they have hot cocoa there.
That's true, yeah.
And there's a bunch of elves running around.
The South Pole and Antarctica are...
What's the difference?
I think one's on the top of the Earth and one's on the bottom.
What?
Yeah.
What?
So both of them are really cold. So it kind of depends on which side of the Earth is facing the sun. I'm just gonna lock in refrigerator. Because I know the freeze is really cold. I don't really know.
Why did you say all that and then just lock in the refrigerator? That's my guess, by the way. Back off.
Because the freezer is like really
super cold. Super cold.
Yeah.
That's where I make my popsicles.
That's true, guys.
What's the difference between Antarctica and the South Pole? I thought Antarctica is the South Pole.
I don't know. That's why I'm just gonna guess the fridge, because I don't know the difference.
I'm getting stressed out, bro.
Yeah, me too. Me too.
I think it's the South Pole.
Okay.
It's gotta be cold down there.
All right, Judd's gonna lock in the South Pole. I will lock in the fridge.
And what happens to the temperature when it gets cold? It goes down.
Oh, south.
South, South Pole.
What? Antarctica.
I thought those were the same thing, bro. Are you serious? Okay, what is this, bro? What comes after a trillion? What is that?
What comes after a trillion?
Oh, a trillion.
Is it a billion, quadrillion, quintillion, or a Google?
What? The answer D's. What is this, guys? What is this, math school, dude? I don't know. Oh, it's probably a billion.
Well,
a billion's huge.
I think it goes thousands.
What? Here we go.
Millions.
Again. Nonsense. Red, orange, yellow. You just prove you don't know your numbers, bro.
Billions and then trillions. I think trillion is bigger than a billion. So I think it's Google. Because I think Google...
Blah, 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 Google. That's all I heard.
I think Google, I remember my mom was telling me what it was. She said it was like a number so big that you can't even understand it.
That's the number 100 to you.
Yeah, that's
your
true.
Your mom's making stuff up. That Google, D, you Google stuff on the internet.
And they misspelled it,
that's
too.
That's what I'm saying. You really got tricked by that? You said Google?
I'm just going to lock it in. I'm just going to
lock gotta it. It's got to be quintillion.
Quintillion?
Yeah.
Wow.
That sounds big, quintillion.
Yeah.
All of these sound big.
All right, let's see what it is.
It's quadrillion, bro.
Man, I thought that was an animal.
No, that's a quesadilla.
Oh, right.
You're not even thinking. What is this, bro? What do snakes smell with? What a silly question. Their nose, dude.
Do they smell with their nose, their eyes, their scales?
How do you smell with your eyes? What is this, dude?
Or their tongue.
Did you make this quiz, Adam?
No, or else I know all the answers.
How do they smell with their eyes? What does that even mean?
Maybe snakes
have
like...
How you smell with your scales? Ew!
Maybe snakes have like a special sensor in their tongues? That's why they're always like flicking their tongue out so they can like smell what's around them.
What? Is that why you do it?
No, I think it's like...
You always do that.
You know how when someone like makes cookies and it smells really good? Like, what if the snake could literally like stick its tongue out and then like lick the scent of the cookies in the air?
Hey, yo, you can lick the scent in the air?
Maybe a snake has the ability to do that because its nose isn't very good. I think it's the tongue.
I think it's scales. I think this is actually a trick question.
Why?
What do snakes smell with? Like, what makes them smell? Like, they smell. Like, what makes a fish smell fishy? It's scales.
Right. That's true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's gotta be the scales. Like, a fish, like, it'd be like, oh, it smells like rotten fish in here.
Right.
And what makes the fish smelly? Scales.
Okay, Jesse's gonna lock in scales. I'm gonna lock in tongue.
If I get this, I'm a certified genius. I won an award.
What? Okay, it was the tongue.
You're hacking. I don't know how you are, but you're hacking, and I won't stand for it. Okay, what is this, bro? How many seasons are in a year?
Bonus points for naming them.
Okay, salt, pepper. It's so funny. You laugh at me. You laugh at me. You laugh at me.
I think those are seasonings.
That's what it said. You laugh at me.
No.
Smart. But I'm smart.
It said how many seasons, like summer, winter.
What?
Like seasons in the year, not seasoning.
Salt, pepper, cinnamon, and that's it.
Garlic.
What?
I think that's also a seasoning.
Okay, so it's four.
Okay.
Salt, pepper, cinnamon, and garlic. Four.
Okay.
I named them, so I get bonus points.
I think it means seasons, like summer, winter, and I think There's summer, winter.
Okay, two. Summer and winter.
Spring.
What?
And fall. So I think there's four.
I said four. You're trying to steal my answer.
Well, I think I'm gonna get bonus points for naming them all.
I named them already. Salt, pepper, cinnamon, and garlic.
Alright, we're both gonna lock in four. Let's see if it's right.
If I get this right, I'm a genius.
I'm a genius!
What instrument does Monty Gator from Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach play? Now we got guitar, violin, trumpet, or piano.
Okay guys, think back to Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach. Now these questions are gonna get harder and harder.
Now, this is really tricky because when I think of the band, you know, Glam Rock Freddy Superstar, he does the singing, he does the vocals.
Right.
I think Chica plays the guitar.
Oh, right.
I think Roxanne Wolf also plays the guitar. So I think Monty might be on the drums.
Oh, but wait, the drums are not an option. I seem to remember playing back. I thought Chica was on guitar, Roxy was trumpet, and Monty Gator was the piano.
Yeah, he does have some swag. Like, I could see him playing the piano. But I feel like he looks like a rock star. So I think he'd be playing a guitar, or maybe it's a violin.
Oh, the violin, it's very pretty. I'm gonna lock in piano on this one.
You don't think it's the trumpet?
I don't think it's the trumpet. I think Roxy Wolf plays the trumpet.
Adam plays trumpet in band class.
Right, that's true.
Yeah.
Justin plays the triangle.
Yeah, I'm real good at it.
Alright.
So funny!
Alright, what are you gonna lock in?
I'm gonna lock in the guitar, bro. He's a rock star.
Alright, let's see what it is.
It was the guitar!
Wow!
Yeah! Okay, now how does boyfriend wear his hat? Front, sideways, backwards, or no hat? What's the
Yeah, I don't think no hat is the answer, but the rest are all actually
so
very
funny.
Tricky.
Okay, I know how to solve this. Guys, this is like what I do at school, because this is a multiple choice question. Sometimes you gotta do an experiment. So I got my cool hat that Adam Bomb bought me at the mall.
Yeah.
I can wear it front ways.
Oh.
Do I look like boyfriend?
A little bit, yeah. A little bit.
Do I look like boyfriend?
A little bit, yeah. Maybe
okay,
try
sideways. We'll try it, guys. Maybe this will help you.
I don't think it's sideways. Guys, Justin loves this hat.
It's my favorite hat. I wear it and I feel smarter. Or is it backwards? Backwards or no hat? Okay, I don't think it's no hat because this photo of him is no hat. And I don't think that's how he looks. He's wearing a hat.
Yeah, he definitely has a red hat. I think
front ways?
I think it was wearing the front.
I don't think it's front ways. I think it's either sideways or backwards. But how do I know if it's front or sideways?
Guys, I will lock in front. Let's see what Justin locks in.
I think he wear it sideways. Because that's like disrespectful to like Daddy Dearest, you know what I mean?
Right, Daddy Dearest.
So like it's front ways, and when it gets all intense, he turns it sideways.
Oh, okay.
That's what I do. That's what I do.
All right, Justin's gonna lock in sideways.
I'm gonna lock in sideways. What are you doing, front?
I'm going front.
All right, let's see. Oh, it's backwards. Guys, but that looks sideways to me, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Man, we got that one wrong. Make sure you guys are playing along at home and let us know in the comments how many you guys get right now. What color is the first grab pack you get in Poppy Playtime?
Okay, now obviously in chapter 2, we all remember that we have the new green hand, but in chapter 1, the first grab pack, I think it's blue and pink for Huggy Wuggy and Kissy Missy?
Nah, bro, nah.
What do you think?
I know one of the colors is red.
Oh.
It's gotta be red. It's either A or C, bro. Red and blue or red and green. Well, the green one is in chapter 2. It can hold the electrical charge.
Right.
Is it green and blue? No, that's chapter 2.
I thought you just said chapter 2 is red and green.
What?
Is chapter 2 green and blue or red and green?
I don't know! I don't know!
Well, A would make sense because if you mix red and blue, you get purple.
Bruh. Okay? Bruh.
And Justin has purple hair.
Okay.
I think red and blue sounds correct, but green also sounds right because green has the electrical charge.
I'm gonna lock in red and blue. I'm gonna take A as the answer.
I think it's green and blue.
All right, Justin's gonna lock in green and blue.
That's what it is in chapter two.
Okay, let's see what the answer is.
Okay.
It was red and blue.
All right. Okay, now what should you not do at 3 a.m.? Okay, watch Sonic.exe movie. Don't do, we've done that. Don't do it.
It's a bad idea.
A mysterious hole appeared in the wall of our room. I don't know what happened. I think it was evil Sonic.
No, you just got a little bit spooked and you kicked the hole.
No, I didn't!
All right.
No, I didn't!
You gotta read the rest of the answers.
Okay, should you call Talking Ben? No, we did that too. And we got Curse.exe Ben Angela hacked.
Right.
Talking Ben was sitting there on the phone. He said, hop my dog. And then hacked our brains.
Right.
I don't like it.
Right.
Now, next is order a Happy Meal. Definitely don't do that. We ordered like the Turning Red May Lee Happy Meal at 3 a.m.
We have ordered.
Yeah.
You have ordered.
No, you order a 3 a.m. Luca Happy Meal once.
All right, I might have ordered one or two.
Don't think I forgot about that.
All right. Or is it all of the above?
Man, this is the worst. In school, when they do that, it's A, B, C, or D is all of the above. How am I supposed to know? That's a trick question.
I feel like you shouldn't do any of these things.
You definitely don't do A, because crazy stuff will happen, and evil Sonic attacked me and put a hole in the wall of our room, okay? Talking Ben, don't do that either, because he will hop back down on you.
Right.
And you don't want that, okay?
Okay.
Don't order a Happy Meal either. We've done that. We ordered the Huggy Wuggy Happy Meal. We ordered an Encanto Happy Meal. No, don't do that. It will curse you, EXE. Adam will drink all the milk and steal the toy from your Happy Meal. So it's all the above. You shouldn't do any of these.
Yeah, I think we're in agreement. I'm going to lock in all the above as well.
We're locking in D. It was D! Okay, now how many legs does this spider have? But this is tricky. This is a photo of Spider-Man, and he got two legs.
That's true. But is Spider-Man a spider, or is he a human in a spider suit?
Spider-Man. He's a man who's a spider.
But he's not just a spider. Because I feel like when you want to look at spiders, you should look at like an actual spider like Mommy Longlegs.
She has two legs. Should we get locked in too?
Oh man, this is tricky because I guess it's like, do you count the arms and the legs as each leg?
No, it's arms. What do you mean you count arms as legs? How many legs does Rocky have?
None.
What?
He's a rock.
No. How many legs does a spider have? That's two. And Mommy Longlegs has two. So Adam's going to lock in two.
Okay, I'll take two as my answer. What are you going to do?
I know a spider, Spooter, something about spiders have eight of something. Is it legs or eyeballs?
It could be both, yeah, because I think spiders have like a bunch of eyeballs all over their head.
I think that's true. I think spiders have four legs. Like, I saw a Daddy Long Legs in real life once, and he had four legs.
Oh, nice.
Or like Doc Ock. He's got four tentacles.
Right.
And he's a Spider-Man.
Yeah, Doc Ock is a spider.
I think it's four. I can't imagine.
Are you sure Doc Ock is not like an octopus?
Bruh.
Guys,
I don't know.
Justin has been doing that when my mom has been teaching us. She hates it.
If she said something I don't agree with, put on my hat. Are you sure, Miss MacArthur?
He'll do that. My mom will ask, like, what's 2 + 2? He'll raise his hand, and then he'll just do that for, like, an hour.
Yep.
Yeah, all right, what is the answer? I'm gonna lock in two.
I'm locking four, because I'm being serious. Like, when I think of, like, a tarantula, it can't have eight legs. Look how many legs that is.
Okay,
that'd
guys.
That'd be like Rocky. Look, it'd be like if he had like this many legs.
Oh, that'd be creepy.
Look, that's 4 and 4. That's 8. No, wait. It's either 4 or 6. I think it's 4.
Okay.
All right. You're lucky too.
Yeah.
It's 8. Are you kidding me? Guys, let us know at home if you got that one right in the comments, because I really honestly thought it was 4. That's crazy. Okay, now this is a really max level difficulty question. What are the powers in Encanto called? Well, I mean, they're obviously called powers because it said, this is something I use in school, guys. It's the answer is in the question. What are the powers of Encanto called? Powers, duh. Mm. I'm locking in A. That's
but the in the movie, I seem to remember them calling them like something else.
Okay.
Okay,
doors, magic doors, B. I changed from A to B.
Guys, is the answer powers, magic, gifts, or sorcery? I think to remember.
It's B, bro. Because magic doors. You know what I mean? Magic doors.
The magic candle.
That's what I'm saying.
I seem to remember something in the movie. Maybe it was during the We Don't Talk About Bruno music video. I think they said something about gifts.
I don't know about that. You think it's gifts?
Yeah.
Wait, why?
I seem to remember Mirabelle being like, oh, I wish I had a gift.
No, she
like
says, I wish I had a magic door. I think it's magic. I think it's magic.
Okay, I'm gonna lock in gifts on this
one. Think it's magic, honestly, bro. I think it's magic. All right, guys, let us know what you think it is. I'm gonna lock in B for magic. Adam's gonna do C for gifts. Let's see what it is. It was gifts!
Wow!
What? Okay, now what band did May Lee from Turning Red want to see? Now, this is nuts, bro. Four Town,
Justin Bieber, Small Town, or Lanky Box. Now I know it's not Lanky.
No, it might be.
I do not think anyone wants to see it.
Goo goo goo, turn into a baby. It might be Lanky Box.
Maybe.
I don't know. You're the one who watches this movie on repeat. Small Town.
This one, I'm pretty sure I know, but I'm not gonna say my answer because I think Justin might try to steal it.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
It's not a competition.
I don't know. I sing this band song all the time.
It might have been Justin. He got that song,
Maylee, oh.
You know what I mean?
Thought you would always be a panda.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, Justin's gonna lock in Justin Bieber.
Yeah, if I was your panda, I'd never let you go. I think it's Justin Bieber.
Okay, I'm gonna lock in 4 Town. Which?
I'm gonna switch my answer to 4 Town. Because Adam watches this movie every day. I know he knows the answer.
All right, let's see what the answer is.
All right, I think it's 4 Town, bro. It's 4 Town!
Got it! You're never not by my
let's
side.
Let's go, dude. Okay, now what is this? How many brains does an octopus have? What a ridiculous question. It's 1. How do you have more than 1 brain?
1, 4, 8, or 9.
Well, it has 8 legs. I know that.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, that's not like it. Oh, wait, so octopus and spiders might be related.
Yeah, it's kind of like a spider is like a land octopus.
Ah. Oh.
Yeah, that's actually really cool.
I never thought about that. They might be brothers.
Yeah, I think, don't cows have like 15 stomachs or
what
something?
What did you just say?
I think an octopus might have.
No, what'd you just say about cows? What are you talking about? Milk!
I thought cows had like multiple stomachs. Oh, hey, what up, Milky?
What are you talking about, bro?
Oh, yeah, Milky grew up on a farm, so he would know.
He says cows do not have 15 stomachs. What are you saying?
That's where they hold the milk.
Milky milk.
I don't actually know.
Milky milk. Okay, it's obviously 1, guys. How does an animal have more than 1 brain? It doesn't even, well, I have 2, actually, so. I have the one that I'm using right now, then I have the other, and that one I only turn on sometimes. It's 1.
I'm gonna go with 4.
Okay, why?
Just a guess.
Okay.
1 is 9 away. An octopus has more brains than tentacles?
We don't know if this is true. Maybe, guys, if you're in school and this is a question on a test, don't go off what we tell you, because this might not be scientifically accurate. I'm thinking It might have one brain in the head and one in all the legs.
All so right, nine. The suction cups.
What?
Okay, let's go.
Okay, now it says, what is the tallest animal in the world? A whale, a giraffe, an ostrich, or a camel? Now, this is very difficult, guys. I'm thinking it's a whale.
That would make sense because I think the biggest animal in the world is a whale.
No, no, that's a giant squid.
Oh, right, yeah.
I'm a squid kid.
But the squid is not an option on this test.
I was actually raised by a giant squid. Underwater.
That's true, guys. Justin was raised by a squid.
I was born on the bottom of the ocean.
That's true, in a little egg.
Bruh. True.
Yeah.
True. I think it's a whale, because if you take a whale who's really long and stand him up on his flipper, he'd be like super tall.
That's true.
Like 400 feet tall or something.
Although a giraffe does have a really long neck. I know it's not an ostrich.
Why? Ostriches have really long neck.
Because a giraffe is definitely taller than an ostrich.
No, how do you know?
Because I went to the zoo like 3 years ago.
An ostrich is a really tall. An ostrich is a bird with a neck almost as long as Adam's. It's crazy. Wait, you turn sideways. Let's see your neck. It might be Adam. It might be.
You think I look like an ostrich?
Nah, I didn't say that.
Really?
I didn't say that. An ostrich is a bird with a really long neck. It might be taller than a giraffe.
I'm a lock-in camel.
Okay, why? A camel also has a long neck.
Yeah, I can't remember the last time I went to the zoo, but I feel like giraffes and camels are both pretty similar, but I feel like a camel might be a little bit taller.
A camel has lumpy humps.
That's true.
It's got two humps on its back that's filled with water. I learned that in school, and it stores water in there. That's how it can go so long without water.
So you're gonna lock in a whale?
Yeah, because a whale is huge, and if you stand it up, it's tall.
Okay, I'm gonna lock in camel.
So, yeah, so like, is Rocky this tall, or is he this tall, right?
That's a good question.
That's what I'm saying.
All right.
I'm gonna go with whale.
Let's see.
What are you locking in?
Camel. It was a giraffe!
No! Okay, now speaking of Rocky, what is a scientist that studies rocks called? This is max level. This, I actually know. Rock star, I think I might have to lock that in because I'm a rock star.
Okay, is it a rock star, a geologist, an astronomer, or a biologist?
Wait, this is really tricky, guys. Okay, rock star, I'm pretty sure that's someone who plays music. So mm-hmm. I actually don't think it's that one.
Like Monty Gator.
Okay, now geologist, I don't think so. Astronomer. That's like SpaceX. That's like Tesla.
Yep.
That's somebody who studies space. Wait a minute. It was a trick. I think it's astronomer because if you study space, what do you study? Planets. And what are planets? Giant rocks.
Oh, that does make sense.
I think it's that, bro.
Biologist. I don't really know what biologist studies.
Biologist. Say it right.
Biologist.
Yeah.
I don't even know what geologists study either, so I'm gonna go with rock star.
I'm a rock star!
Because that would make sense because it has the word rock in its name.
That's what I thought, but that's a trick answer, dude. It's definitely astronomer.
Okay, let's see what the answer
astronomer,
is.
Astronomer, here we go.
What? Geologist!
I thought geologists studied geography, man.
Oh, man.
Okay, well, we didn't get that one. That's okay. Let us know if you guys got that one. That was actually tricky. Okay, now how many bones do sharks have?
Is it 0, 3, 126, or 206?
Yeah!
Hey, thick shark!
Yeah!
Thick shark is super thick!
Yeah! Look at him! Look at him! Okay, how many bones? Dude, yet again, another trick question. Dude, I know, you guys want to know something.
Bruh.
Crazy? Teeth are bones.
Really?
Aren't they?
No, I thought teeth are like teeth.
No, they're bones.
Really?
I'm pretty sure teeth count as bones.
So like in your arm, your bone is a tooth?
No. No!
Then what are you saying?
Teeth all count as bones.
Oh!
It's all the same.
Got it.
It's the same material or something. So sharks have tons of teeth. Even thick shark has tons of teeth. So I'm gonna max level 206.
Oh, that's a good guess.
It has hundreds of teeth.
I'm gonna guess 0.
Oh, yeah, because Thick Shark basically has zero bones. Look at him.
He's yeah, because so Thick Shark's a plushie, and he doesn't have any bones in him because he's super soft and cuddly.
He's the only shark we know. How would it have zero bones? You're being ridiculous. How would you have zero bones? It would just be like a jellyfish.
Right, but that's why I think it is zero, because it doesn't really need bones. It could just swim by, like, wiggling
its body.
What do
you mean? Look at its fin, okay? Right there, that must be bones. How is it standing up if it's no bones? You think it's just filled with jelly?
Yeah, I'm just gonna guess zero. I don't really know why.
Okay, so Adam's gonna go zero. I'm gonna guess max level 206 because I think teeth count as bones.
All right, let's see.
What?
It was zero.
What is Sonic's power? Super strength, teleportation, telekinesis, or super speed?
Okay, guys, these questions are gonna get harder and harder, and there's a bonus question at the end. Now, I'm trying to think, what is Sonic's power?
I'm almost sure it's super speed, because he says, gotta go fast, and he runs fast, but it might be super strength, because he is strong.
I was literally just thinking the same thing.
Look at his arm.
He's able to beat Dr. Eggman and Shadow and Metal Sonic, and you need super strength to do that.
Or is he so fast that he could teleport technically?
But honestly, I feel like super speed has to be the right answer.
Really?
I think so, yeah.
What does telekinesis even mean?
Telekinesis means that you can, like, move stuff with your mind.
I could do that in real life, so I don't think Sonic can do that. I think it's super speed. He always says, gotta go fast!
Alright, let's lock it in.
Okay. It was! Yeah! Okay, what is Glamrock Chica's favorite food? Oh, man. Donut? That's ours, okay? Mm-hmm. Pizza? That's also ours. Spaghetti? Oh, she's not ready for the spaghetti. Or a burger. Dude, all of them. I like all of them.
If you were to swap this question for what is Justin and Foxy's favorite food, it would be every single one of these.
There has to be the choice E, all of the above. I would say it's all of the above. Chica always does say Chica Pizza.
That's true.
But the pizza is what oofed her in Five Nights at Freddy's security breach. We lured her with the pizza and put her in the trash machine.
Right. I feel like for a second she was eating spaghetti in the game.
She was ready for the spaghetti.
Right, but...
And pizza is kind of like spaghetti if you think about it.
That's true.
If you think about it.
I think at the end, right before she got crushed, I thought she was eating spaghetti, so I'm gonna lock in spaghetti.
It might be a burger. Mm. I think it's a burger.
You think so?
Because that sounds like food they would have at the Pizza Plex. Wait a minute. Freddy's Pizza Plex. I think it's gotta be pizza, bro. It's gotta be the Chica Pizza. He's gonna lock in the spaghetti. I have a lock in pizza. It was B!
Yeah!
Okay, now what is Bruno's gift? Can he see the future, control the weather, shapeshift, or talk to animals?
Okay, guys, like we said, these questions are gonna get harder and harder. See if you can actually beat Justin and I.
Okay, I know control the weather and shapeshift are powers from Encanto, but I don't think Bruno did those. I think other people could do those.
Yeah, I think Camilo could shapeshift. I don't remember who could control the weather.
Bro, you watch Encanto? How many times have you seen Encanto?
I have seen Encanto at this point probably like 50 times.
Whoa, and you can't remember who controls the weather? You can't remember, dude?
Well, I don't really know, guys. I think
you've seen it how many times?
50. But
no, you've seen it about 200 times.
Well, okay, I know it's not shapeshift. I think it's either see the future or talk to animals.
That's what I was saying. I think it's talk to animals because he can talk to little rats.
I thought it was see the future because he could, like, see into Mirabelle's future.
What?
Yeah.
What about when his eyes turn green?
That's when I think he could see the future.
Or is that when he can talk to animals?
I don't know. I can't remember, guys.
I could talk to animals.
That's true.
Everybody, I could talk to your dogs right now. If you have dogs, put them in front of the TV. I'll wait. Okay, here we go. I need to talk to animals.
I'm gonna stick with see the future.
Okay, so you're locking in C?
I'm locking in A, see the future.
You're locking in C?
No, A. A is my answer.
Okay, I'm locking D. It was see the future! Okay, now what does Marshall from Paw Patrol do, man?
Is he a firefighter, a police officer, does he do construction, or is he a chef?
He does all the above. He can do it all. Marshall is the best.
I thought Marshall loves eating, and I think he's a chef.
You think he'd be cooking?
Yeah.
I mean, look, I got a hint right here. Look at his badge.
Uh-huh.
There's flames on it. I think you're right. I think it's because the food he makes is so fire.
Right, exactly.
That's fire.
Now, I don't think it's construction, because I think that's what rubble does.
Yep.
Police officer, I think that's what Chase does.
That's Chase.
So it's either firefighter or chef.
Dude.
Now, you watch a lot of Paw Patrol.
I've been messing with Adam this whole time. It's obviously firefighter, bro.
Are you sure?
Yeah, bro. How do you not know this, bro? Obviously firefighter, bro.
Why are you baby talking?
What are you talking about, dude?
Why are you talking like this?
Dude, you talk like this. Every time the camera's off, Adam talks that way. It's starting to infect my brain. It's
your
Adam's
brain?
Fault. It's Adam's fault. No, I didn't say that. Your brain is going in my brain.
It's all my fault.
It is, bro.
I'm a fucking chef.
When the cameras are off, that's how Adam talks, bro. And he be saying crazy stuff. Chef. Chef Boyardee. He calls his mommy a chef. He said, wow, mommy, this food's busting. That's what Adam says, bro. When the cams are off. I think he's a firefighter because I actually watch Paw Patrol. You don't even watch the show.
All right, let's see it.
Obviously, bro.
Oh, guys, did you guys get that one?
Wow. Okay, now what is the name of SpongeBob's pet? Okay, we got Gerald, Jerry, Gary and Rocky. It's not Rocky, bro. Although I know Patrick, he has a pet rock named Rocky.
That's true.
That's a trick question.
I think I know this one because I love SpongeBob.
Yeah.
I think it's Gary the Snail.
You think it's Gerald the Snail?
No. I think it's C, Gary the Snail.
How you know it's not B? It's spelled Gary. That's Gary.
I don't think that's it because I remember in the episodes, SpongeBob would always say, Gary! And I think that's C.
Yeah, how do you know it's not spelled B? Gary! It's spelled Gary.
I think that spells Jerry.
Jerry?
Yeah, guys. I don't know. It's between B and C, but I'm gonna lock in C.
I'm gonna lock in... Mr. Quabs.
That's not an option.
Oh.
Can you read?
What? Yeah, I can read! Don't make it funny, babe! I'm gonna lock in... B for Gary. That's how you spell Gary.
I got it. It was Gary.
Man. Okay, now who is the leader of PJ Masks? This is a real tricky question. Is it A, Catboy, B, Owlette, C, Gecko, or D, Romeo?
Okay, now I know right off the bat it's not Romeo because Romeo's evil. He would never be the leader of PJ Masks.
How do you know?
I love
PJ Masks. He might take over PJ Masks.
That's true. But I think it's either Owlette or Catboy.
Why do you think it's Gecko? Really? Really? You're really gonna say that about Gecko?
I'm pretty sure it's not Gecko because Gecko always says, Gecko! And then he climbs on walls.
What does that have to
stuff.
Do with anything?
I just don't think it's Gecko.
How are you sure it's not Romeo?
Because Romeo is the bad guy in the show. Catboy or Owlette? I'm gonna go Eeny.
You're probably gonna go Owlette.
Eeny, meeny, miny,
moe. He loves Owlette, bro.
Catch a Catboy by the toe. I'm gonna go with Owlette.
I knew it.
Okay, who are you gonna
Adam
pick?
Adam thinks he's Owlette. Let me just put it out there, bro.
Yeah, sometimes.
He jumps up and down on his bed and he says, I can fly, mommy. Thinks he's Owlette. It's obviously Catboy, bro.
All right, let's see.
It's Catboy.
Nice.
Okay, now who sings in Five Nights at Freddy's? Wait a minute, I thought they all sang. Okay, we got Monty, Chica, Roxy, or Freddy?
Okay. I remember in the other question, Chica, the one about pizza, she was holding a guitar. So I think that she plays guitar.
Yeah,
in the
you
group.
Can play guitar and sing at the same time.
That's true. The other three, I don't know. Maybe one of them like plays the drums or something.
What?
Foxy, what do you think?
Foxy says, I think you sing, Aiden. Adam does sing a lot. He likes to sing.
Right.
I think it's Monty, because Monty looks like a rock star.
That's true. I was thinking I was thinking Monty, too.
I was thinking,
I was thinking Monty.
You were thinking Woxy? That's how you talk, bro. When the cameras are off, Adam talks that way, it's infecting my brain.
I'm gonna lock in A, Monty.
You're gonna walk in Monty? I was gonna do Monty. Why you steal my answer, bro?
Because I think you're right. Sometimes I'll just do this on tests, guys. It's like, I think Justin's a genius, so I'll just like kind of do what he does.
You admit to cheating!
No!
Adam cheats! He just admitted it.
But then we always end up getting them wrong anyway.
You copy my answer? right?
Yeah, but you normally get them wrong.
No, I don't! I'm gonna lock in Monty. It's probably Monty. I don't think Roxy or Chica. Does Freddy sing? I think it's Monty.
Okay, let's see.
It was Freddy!
Oh, man!
Okay, what does Poppy say? Okay, she says, you open my... Okay, this must be at the end of chapter one.
Yeah, was it, you open my box, you open my case, you open my chest, or you open my cage? I think I know this one.
Well, she's sitting in a box at the end of chapter one, so I'm tempted to say it's A.
That's true, but I seem to remember, because we played Poppy Playtime so much, I seem to remember her saying, you open my case. I think it's case.
Or was it a cage?
You open my cage. Oh, that could be it too.
Was it chest? That's what Adam says to his mommy.
It's not chest.
You opened my chest and filled it with love. That's what he says.
I don't think it's that though.
And it's a different chest, like a treasure chest.
Right, not like your heart. I don't think it's box either. You open my box. That doesn't sound right.
I don't think it's me, Adam.
I don't think it's you, Boxy. I think it's case. I'm unlocking case.
I think it's cage because she was trapped by mommy. I think it's cage.
All right, let's see what's right.
I'm locking D. It was cage.
Got it.
Man. Okay, now who says just keep swimming? Now, this is characters from Finding Nemo.
Okay, is the answer Nemo, Dory, Marlin, who's the dad, or Crush, who's the turtle?
What? Marlin? Oh, Marlin's the deity fish?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, from Finding Nemo.
I think it's Crush, right? Because he's like, go with the flow, just keep swimming or something.
Yeah, Crush.
Wait a minute.
Oh, because Crush, the turtle, they would ride like those water, like...
The currents.
Currents, right. And I think that was what he was saying. Just keep swimming through the currents.
Just keep swimming, you can find me.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
What? I know it's Dory! What's so funny, dude? Get in the camera. Tell everyone what's so funny.
You mean Dory?
As I said.
What did you say?
I said Dory.
Oh, got it. Got it.
What are you laughing at?
Got it.
What are you laughing at?
I don't know. I think it's Crush the turtle.
It's Dory.
All right,
she
guys.
Says, just keep swimming. Just keep swimming.
Justin's gonna lock in Dory. You got
whoever
it?
Whoever says it, sings it. I think Dory's the only one who sings. I'm a genius, bro.
Okay, let's see who's right.
Let's go!
Oh, it was Dory!
Okay, what color is boyfriend's hat? I can read. I can't read.
I think it says, which color is boyfriend's hair?
I know that. That's what I said.
Is it black, blonde, red, or blue? Guys, think, boyfriend, what color is his hair?
What's so funny? Explain.
Nothing. Funny. Nothing.
When the cameras are off, Aiden be infecting my brain. It's starting to take a toll on me.
Right, guys. Now, I'm pretty sure I think it's blue because I remember seeing boyfriend. I think his hair is blue. I'm like 90% sure. Although it could be black if it's like an EXE version. Cause yeah, when boyfriend gets infected by EXE, his hair does turn black. So I don't know, it's either A, black, or D, blue.
I don't know what you just said. It's clearly blue, man.
You sure?
I'm pretty sure it's light blue. Am I losing my mind?
I'll go with black only because I think boyfriend.exe, his hair is black.
It's blue, man.
You sure?
I'm pretty sure.
All right, guys, just gonna lock in blue.
All right. It was!
Oh!
Yeah! Okay, what instrument does Bunzo Bunny play?
Is it the cymbals, the drums, the guitar, or the triangle? This one's
That's tricky.
Tricky,
man, because drums and cymbals are like the same thing.
That's true, guys. They're the same instrument.
So is the triangle.
Right, guys. So you don't think it's guitar?
What?
You don't think it's guitar?
I don't think it's the guitar. What? Stop laughing at me.
Okay,
what
guys.
What is so funny?
Okay, guys. Okay. So Justin does not think it's the guitar. So your answer is A, B, and D?
It's one. No, I'm still figuring out.
Okay, what is it?
One of them. Dude, what are you laughing at? What are you laughing at?
The drums?
What are you What are you saying?
Or the triangle?
What are you saying? See, Adam talks this way when the cameras are off.
I think it's either A, cymbals, or B, drums. I don't think it's triangle.
It might be the triangle. Because what color is his hat, or what shape is his hat?
A triangle.
Yeah.
The party hat.
That's what I'm saying. And what shape is a carrot? Twang. What is so funny? Laugh one more time, see what happens. You said you would laugh! I'm almost sure it's a triangle.
Okay, I'm gonna lock in symbol, A.
Okay,
let's see. Bang! I got it!
That was close. Okay, what color? He's talking burns. Chair. Bang, bang, bang.
Is it red, green, orange, or gray? Do you think you know this one?
Yes. Bang. Bang. Yes. No, no. Mine.
Mine. What do you think the answer is?
Mine.
You can't just do impressions of Ben. I think it's green. I think it's green, guys, because when I think of Talking Ben, I think that he's like in a green background.
I got the answer, obviously.
What is
so it? Obvious, it's orange.
Guys, I don't know what's wrong with Justin today.
So obvious. You locking green?
Yes, I'm gonna lock in green. Not green. Hi, Gwosty.
What are you doing, man?
It's green,
You're
guys.
You're messing around this whole video.
I know it's B.
Take it serious, bro.
I am. What do you think it is?
I just told you what I think it is. I think it's orange.
Okay, guys.
That's the color I think of when I think of Talking Bean.
Justin's going to lock in C, orange. I'm going to lock in B, Mark. Green.
Mark. Let's see what it is.
Wow!
Wait, why did I think orange? I actually thought it was orange. That's the color of his phone, dude.
Oh, man.
What's this little IQ testing, Roblox?
Yeah, so basically this game is gonna ask us a bunch of super tough questions and we gotta see which one of us in this video is gonna be smarter.
Okay, okay, it says touch the picture of an ice cream. Oh, I'm super good at this. Oh,
I was already standing on
ice cream,
it.
I got it. See, okay, that was easy, bro. I mean, come on, bro.
But not all the questions are gonna be that simple.
Are you sure, bro?
Yes.
You sure? Okay, all right, I got plus one. Wait, some people got yeeted off that. What? Touch the picture, okay, of a tiger, okay, okay.
Oh what?
That's kind of difficult, bro. Okay, this one.
It's this one. What?
That's the Lion King, bro.
Wait, really? No! I got yeeted.
Are you serious? That's the lion, bro.
I never saw the Lion King.
The color orange is named after the fruit. Wait, what?
Is the color orange named after the
fruit? How am I supposed to know? I'm gonna say false. I would say false. There's no way that's true.
Why else would an orange be called an orange?
I don't know.
Oh, I got plus one.
I got yeeted. Hey, there's no way. How is that? How could they prove that? Adults have fewer bones than babies.
That's true.
Let me just check. Nah, he's got more bones in that neck. I got it.
We didn't pick an answer.
What's the answer?
I think it's false.
You cannot oof from drinking too much water. Yes, you can. Yes, no, you can oof. So that's
because,
false.
Yeah, you don't have enough salt in your body.
Okay, but you're on the wrong one, my friend. You're on the wrong one, my friend. This person loves our Godios. Our videos. Yeah!
Oh,
I got knew that one. Cause, hey, y'all already know, guys. Hey, I stay real hydrated. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You gotta be careful. Once I drink too many of these, your mom got mad. She said it's dangerous. She taught me. It is possible. It's very difficult, but you can overhydrate, guys.
Yeah.
Touch the picture of a baseball. Oh, I was already on it. Okay,
oh, nice. Cool.
Okay, now this game, okay, it's kind of difficult. I'm not gonna lie. My brain, it's getting taxed. Okay, mentally, Google was originally called back rub. What?
False.
That's false, bro. What are you talking
Google
about,
is
bro?
Google.
Back rub is what Adam's mom gives him when he can't fall asleep. What?
Oh, no.
Was it really called that before? Nah.
I guess so.
Are they making stuff up? Touch the picture of a basketball. Hey, yeah.
I know sports when I see one. It's this one. Oh, dunk it, Justin. Oh!
Oh, splish splash. You know what I mean?
Fun fact. This isn't funny.
Let's go.
Wait, did they ever? So that's a fan that put that up there. They're doing you. Yeah. And when you always say that's not funny, they paid to say that.
That's not funny.
Exactly. The top of the Eiffel Tower leans away from the sun.
What?
True.
How would it lean away from the sun?
I learned this in Miraculous Ladybug.
Why would it lean away from the sun? Why?
Because it's afraid of the sun.
What?
It's like a plant, but the opposite. Because you know how plants sometimes grow towards the sun? Touch the picture of a cheetah.
What did you just say about plants growing?
Plants grow towards the sun.
How does that do with the Eiffel Tower?
Because the Eiffel Tower is not a plant.
I know that.
Justin really thought the Eiffel Tower was a plant.
I didn't. You lied! You made that up!
This video is called Are You Smart? And clearly, I am!
I said no such thing! You wouldn't do no such thing! Explain! Explain it! Explain it or else! Explain it or else!
Alright, I'll admit, I actually don't know why it does it. I just guess.
Press the lightest blue square.
The lightest blue
what?
Square?
Oh, it's this one.
I think it means like brightest, like this one.
Adam got it wrong.
Let me see.
We all got it.
Wait, that one girl didn't.
How did they get it right, bro?
I don't know.
Touch the picture of a cat.
Okay, I know cats when I see it.
Wait, there's two pictures of cats. I'll go with this one. Adam's gonna get oofed.
It's a kitty
cat.
That's probably
a kitten. You're probably gonna get oofed. Oh, they mean two cats. Oh. Pick a friend and stand near him slash her. No, get away, Adam, get away.
All right, I'm next to this person.
I'm gonna hang out with this person who's trying to school you, who says that it's two cats. Autocorrect. All right. I feel bad. This person doesn't have a friend. They get oofed. Don't get oofed. Oh, no!
Aww.
And they're a big tan. Can. Huh?
They probably meant big fan.
Oh,
their name's Bruh Kid.
Bruh.
Touch Mars. Oh,
okay.
Boy.
Adam got no idea. Which one is it, Adam?
It's this one.
Yeah, it's this one, dude. I know because I'd be learning from Mars. Which one of the five is least like the others? Okay. A statue, a poem, a painting, a flower, or a novel?
I'm going to say a statue.
It's a flower, dude.
Because a poem is not alive.
And a novel is?
And I guess I'm not alive.
Okay.
Guys, so the answer of the Eiffel Tower thing is the sun facing side of the tower heats up, and so it causes the tower to grow on one side a little bit more. And so that's why it leans away from the sun.
What?
Like, the sun heats up the metal, which when things heat up, they expand, right? And so that's why the one side of the tower expands a little bit more, so it leans away from the sun. Because it's like, this is the hot side, and it's heating up, so it's leaning.
That actually makes sense.
press the rectangle. Man, Foxy and Boxy gotta help us on this one.
All right, the rectangle. Foxy, Boxy, yeah, guys, they got a video about shapes. Hey, it's this one right here, bro.
I think you're right, yeah.
Bro, this is a trick question, though, because aren't squares all rectangles?
It's one of the things where it's like all rectangles aren't squares, but all squares are
That's
rectangles.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Every one of those squares was a rectangle, bro. Hey, big brain. Press the orange button 10 times, okay? Okay, well, wait, how do you press it? One, two, three, four, five. Wait, what? It's gone.
Oh, boy. I think we messed it up.
Uh-oh, this person said no. Oh, no, bruh. Kid, not like that.
Ah!
Wait, how did these people get it right? Wait, what? Wait, what? Touch the picture of a soccer ball, okay? It's this one.
Oh, yeah.
And weren't you a soccer referee at one point? How'd you not?
I never said I was a good one.
Didn't think about that. He was on a basketball court trying to play soccer, bro. The space between your eyebrows is called the
Rosetta. I'm gonna say that's false.
False.
I think that's a type of cheese. Rosetta cheese.
This leg box makes me die of laughter. Thank you. Okay. Because we're here talking about, he's talking about cheese. Touch the picture of a puma. All right. Well, it's a puma, bro. Oh, bro. I think it's that one. I didn't touch it. I think it's this one over here.
Yeah.
I think it was this one. Yeah, it was that one. Wow. This person's really smart. Okay. Okay, let's go. Okay. Press the button.
Okay.
Oh.
This one.
Press the button.
Did we do it all right?
Press this one.
Guys, leave a like and subscribe. Go check out LeggyBoxShop.com. Get yourself some LeggyBox merch today.
This video proved that we're smart. Time for some Pop-Tarts.
Hey.